Hey everyone, my name is Kajal and welcome to another Webots tutorial video in Python. In today's Webot tutorial video, we are doing a fun project of a line follower robot. A line following robot is a great way to get started with robotics and only requires basic level 1 coding skills. We will start by setting up our environment in Webots. Next, we will add a robot from the Webots library, which is epuck, and add IR sensors. Then we will write our code, which is controller in Webots in Python. I'll go over how to detect the line using infrared sensors and use those values to make a line following robot in Webots. I've included the timings here and in the description below. So without further ado, let's get into it. We will start by creating a new project. Give a name. I'm calling mine my project line follower epuck and click continue. Make sure to select add a rectangular arena and click continue. Click done. This will load a new world in Webots. Let's add a robot in our Webots world. I'm using epuck. You can use any robot you want, including your own custom robot. Click on the plus sign. Click on proto nodes. Click on robot and then scroll down till you see GCtronics. Select epuck, and click add. This will add the epuck robot to your Webots world. Make sure to save your work. Next, our robot needs sensing ability to detect the line. This can be done using infrared sensors or even cameras. We'll be using infrared sensors, also known as IR sensors. In epuck, there is a ground sensor slot available, and this is where we will add our sensors. Click on the plus sign to add a node. Initially, I couldn't find IR sensor in Webots. Turns out they are available under distance sensor, and I will show you how to access them in just a few minutes. Under base node, select distance sensor and click add. In your scene tree, go to distance sensor and under distance sensor, scroll down to type. As you can see, there are options for infrared, sonar and laser. Select infrared. To visualize this sensor in Webots, let's enable the rays. Go to views, optional rendering and select show distance sensor rays. Our sensor is in the ground slot. So let's go under the rectangular arena. As you can see, there's a ray pointing downward and this is our IR sensor in Webots. Now let's move our sensor a little bit to the left. In your scene tree, go to the distance sensor. In translation, make y equal to minus 0.01 meter. To move the sensor by 1 centimeter in left. We will also change the name, making it easy to access the sensor from our controller. Select name and then type IR0. Similarly, let's add a second IR sensor. Click on the plus sign, base nodes, distance sensor, and add. Under distance sensor, go to type and select infrared. Next, let's move this sensor to right by changing translation. Make y is equal to 0.02 meter. We will name this sensor IR1. Our last step in setting up the environment is creating a line or a track for the robot to follow. In real world, this is usually a colored tape. I'm using one that was made by DragerDG Robotics YouTube channel. It's a pretty awesome channel and I'll add a link to their channel in the description below. I've converted this model to a proto node, making it easy to use. I'll add a link in the description below. Just download it and add it to the proto folder of your Webots project. Now let's add this track to our Webots world. Click on the plus sign and select it from the proto current projects. Click add. As you can see, it has been imported in our Webots world. I'm going to move it so that it's closer to the floor. Select track 1, select transition and make y is equal to minus 0.0075. Since our arena is small for the track, let's make it bigger. In the Webots tree scene, select rectangular arena and floor size and make it 2x2. Now a line follower robot essentially works by detecting the colored line using IR sensors. So to give it a good contrast, let's make our floor white. For this, select floor appearance and click on convert to base node. This is something that can be done with any proto nodes and allows you to make changes to the internal properties of a node. Under floor appearance, go to base color map, right click and select reset to default value. This makes our floor white. Now let's work on our controller. Click on wizards, New robot controller, and I'm going to select Python. Remember, you can use any programming language. Next, give it a name. I'm going with my controller line follower. Click continue and done. This will open up your controller file in the Webots editor. Let's start with the basic code. Create a robot instance, turn on both of our motors and drive the robot straight. I'm going to speed this up as I have another detailed tutorial on this. I will add a card here and also include the link to that video in the description below. Make sure to save the code and update your epuck to use the new controller that we just wrote in Python. To do this, go to the same tree on the left and select epuck. Click on controller and select. Scroll through the list and select your controller and click OK. As always, make sure to save your work. And now let's run the simulation in Webots. Looks like I forgot an import statement. Let me quickly make that correction in my code, save it and run the simulation again. As you can see, our robot epuck is now driving straight. I'm going to take some time here to explain how infrared sensors work and how we will detect the line. Infrared sensors essentially have a light emitter and a detector. A light emitter throws light. This light is absorbed and reflected back. Depending on the type of material and color, different objects will emit light differently. And the detector in the infrared sensor will detect the reflected light back. Based on the value of light that was reflected back, we can detect different objects. And then we use this information to differentiate between our floor and our line. Now let's go back to our controller code in Webots and look at the infrared readings. First, we'll create an instance for our sensors and enable them with the timestamp. Most functions in Webot have the similar style of get motor and get distance sensor. There's a page with all of these functions and I will include it in the description below. Next, let's read the values from our infrared sensors using getValue function. I'm also going to print them out so we can see what these values look like. Let's save our code and run the simulation. On the output console, you can see the infrared sensor values. Let's move our robot so we can see what the value looks like when it crosses the track. Also, if you're like me and keep forgetting which axis is in which direction, you can turn on the coordinate system. This time, I'll use the step function instead of the play function so we can run the simulation one step at a time. Observe the output console to understand how the value changes as it goes from the white floor to our track. Now let's use this information to run our robot on the track. I want to quickly show how you can turn a differential drive robot. I'm doing this by giving positive speed to one wheel and negative speed to another wheel. And when you flip these signs, you can see the robot turns in another direction. I've explained all of this in detail in another video and I'll link it in the cards on the corner or in the description below. At this point, I encourage you to pause this video and think about how to solve this problem first and then watch the rest of the video. Alright, so we have two infrared sensors giving us information about the objects that it detects, which in this case is floor and the track. And because we saw the readings on the output console, we know the value ranges when it detects floor and when it detects the line. So all we need is a simple if-else condition to detect the line and turn the epoch accordingly. So if this left sensor detects black line, means the robot needs to turn left. And if the right sensor detects the line, it has to go right. So let's write that code in our editor. Let's save our work and run the simulation in Webots. As you can see, the robot is following the line and turning as and when required. And if you observe it closely, the motion is a bit jerky. And then there comes a point where the robot leaves the line. One of the reasons for this could be the robot turned too quickly and ended up leaving the track completely. And now because it doesn't see the line anymore, it doesn't know where to go and it simply keeps driving straight. A solution to this is to slow down our robot so that it doesn't turn this fast. And it will also make the robot movement more smooth. Let's go back to our Webots editor and reduce the speed by a quarter of what it was before. Once again, make sure to save your code and let's run our simulation by clicking play on the Webots menu bar. And look at that, the movement is much smoother than before. The robot will continue to follow the track. I'm going to speed it up for now. In general, with the line following robot, you will have to tweak the reading values and the speed of your robot to ensure it follows the line. Any difference in the floor type, color, and even lighting will affect the infrared readings. So make sure to adjust if there is a difference. Lastly, I'm cleaning up the code by removing any unnecessary print statements and adding some quotes for better readability. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to give it a like. If you have any questions or doubts, use the comment section below. Also, if you want me to make more such videos or have specific requests, tell me in the comments below. Also, if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.